Hi everybody, it's Sam at Mixed Up Craft. Thank you for joining me today. I've got another Arteza product review. This time it's the coloured pencils. So I've done the watercolour pencils and now I've got the coloured pencils. I do have other branded coloured pencils. I'm not going to talk about them today, but I will probably do a comparison video in later months. But for now, we're just going to talk about these. So first of all, they look exactly the same as the watercolour tin and the same quantity as well. This is the 72. These ones are circular, whereas the other ones are hexagon. So that's the only difference really. And obviously these are just normal colour pencils and the other ones are watercolour. So really nice variety of colours. I have swatched them, which you'll see in a moment. When I first went to use these, the first thing that kind of stuck out to me was how smooth they were. With a lot of coloured pencils, they can sometimes almost tear your paper. They can be quite harsh and leave kind of like a track in your card or the paper that you're using. These do not do that at all. I got really good coverage. They've got a real high pigment quality to them. And overall, first impressions have been really good with these pencils. So I'm going straight in to show you how I've used them and what I've used them for. So I've just got this stamp here. This is the Woodware Classic Rose Bunch. Really lovely one. I was just prepping it. If you wondered what I was doing before, whenever I have a new stamp, I always rub my hand over it. Some like the natural oils in my hand. I don't know, it just seems to help with the stamp, because when these come from the factories, a lot of the time they have like a chemical on them as such. So give them a wipe sometimes and things like that. And you will find that after you stamp them a few times and just kind of prep them, you'll get a much better impression. So I'm just stamping this onto some 300 GSM craft card. I wanted to see, because when I was swatching them, I thought they had such a strong pigment to them. I thought they would take well on a craft card or a black card stock. So that's why I've chose the craft card today. So the colors I'm using here, this first one I'm going in with is eggplant. I'll also be using fuchsia and then forest green and basil for the leaves and then the white quartz. I wanted to create a real kind of strong highlight to these flowers, and I was pleasantly surprised at just how well that white quartz colored pencil took to the craft card. It just, you can see there the coverage, it's so opaque. It's just, it's really, really good. I absolutely love it. So yeah, this was a joy to create. And the nice thing is, because these pencils are soft, you can blend them. I was able to rub parts of this. So you can see that it's a really, I guess, coloured pencils, particularly these ones, are, I think, maybe a good thing for someone who's never done any colouring at all. And maybe you're a little bit not sure whether to go straight into a watercolour pencil. Usually I would say if you want to do blending and stuff, I would say go to a watercolour or even an alcohol marker. But these I was able to get a really nice blend with, and you do have to work it a bit. So you can see here I am going over it and I go back to it again and I rework it a bit more. But I just really liked that. I thought it was nice. You can also use a rubber to them. I found that I could lift with my rubber. So if I did go over any edges, you know, I could do that. But I do go in at the end with my, I also got the Arteza fine liners. And I just went over the black stamped image just to kind of make that pop a little bit more. So I'm just going through, you know, the colouring these three flowers exactly the same way. So I'm just sticking with those three colours, the eggplant and the fuchsia and then that opaque white. And it just was easy. That's the easiest way to say this. It's easy. They've got so many great colours. So, you know, if this isn't your choice that you'd like to use for flowers or even a rose in this, you know, instance here, there's so many different, you know, ones to choose there. And the great thing about Arteza as well is they're that real kind of they're a nice entry level. The price points are good, and a lot of even expert artists use them as well and rate them. So again, as I said before, with any of these Arteza reviews, although it is a review, they do very, very well. They don't need people to do the reviews because a lot of people have already got the product and love it anyway. So I'm just here to give you my opinion and just to introduce you to it, really, to anybody that hasn't, you know, heard of Arteza or know of them, then you can, you know, have a little look here. So again, you can see there just how there's not much kind of breakage. I'm really pushing down on these. That's another thing I want to point out as well. And that's not because I couldn't get color out of them. That's because I was really kind of, you know, just kind of pushing it into the cardstock, I guess, just to get that really full coverage. So, but there's little breakage. None of my nibs broke. They're really comfortable to hold. And yeah, just loved it. So here I'm blending now. This is the forest green, was the first darker color at the bottom. Then I used that basil. Again, they blended really well. And then I just kind of, you know, tip the ends there of the leaves with that white quartz. And then I go back over again with that basil green, and it just starts to kind of blend and just kind of take away a little bit of that white, because I didn't want as much as I initially had. But yeah, I just really like these. You can see I've gone over the edges, you know, a few times there, but I do go and rub that out. And I also then go in with the black fine liner. So again, if you're worried that you're going to go over the lines and stuff, it's easily, you know, sorted. It's not a problem at all. Now, I did find that once I stamped this, it really felt like that image had lifted off the craft card. It became so 3D, and I think because of the highlight, if you look there now from a distance, it really did look like it was popping out from that cardstock. And again, really enjoyed doing this. So I've now realized that I stamped it originally upside down, so I just flipped the cardstock around and now stamping the sentiment there that also comes with that stamp set. I will link all this in my blog along with a coupon code as well. So if you are interested to purchase the pencils, then I will share the code that you can use. That's valid till the end of May sometime. So now I'm just coming in with some Nuvo drops. I popped this onto a 5x7 card base, and I just thought the white Nuvo drops just again kind of framed that flower and just added a little bit of texture and dimension to the card there as well. And then you will see now that I will bring in the fine liner 0.4. These fine liners are lovely, and they're really good for obviously writing in your cards, but also for adding detail to any stamped images. If you've stamped something and maybe you've missed a bit, it's great to bring in the fine liner. And now you can see just how much that lifts. And look at the lovely kind of shine that you get off of that pencil as well. It's a real wax kind of texture to the top of the stamped image there. Again, I really liked it. I wouldn't put this up if I didn't think it was any good. I think it's going to be great for a lot of you that ask. And like I said, the price points are really, really good. So, and you get loads as well. So, yeah. Thumbs up, Arteza. I really, really liked this one. And yeah, I was a bit surprised because I didn't think I'd do too much with the pencils. I thought, well, I'm not really going to be able to blend them and it's going to take a lot of work, but this didn't. It was really nice to do. So you can just see some stills there, and really pleased with how this has turned out. So again, they will be featuring in more tutorials because I really like them. So I hope this has helped you in some way. If, like I said, it's introduced you, then that's a good thing. Head over to their website. They have tons of great product, and I have been reviewing quite a few bits now, and I've got some more to share with you as well. So until next time, guys, see you then. Bye.